My name is Omri, and today we're going to be playing some Storic. Got this really sweet deck prepared. Black-red Arcanist. And it's a really sweet deck, it's a lot of fun. So, I'm going to do a quick, sort of, couple-minute deck tech, and then jump into some games. Primary game plan of this deck is to land cheap threat, Dreadhorde Arcanist, or Young Pyromancer in most cases, but it can be a reanimated Arcfiend's Vessel, an active Priest of the Forgotten Gods, or even a Croaks after turn 4. The deck backs that up with cheap interaction. It's got Thought Seize, which was one of the best cards in the Historic format, and then Claim the Firstborn, Spark Harvest, Bedevil for removal. It's also got Claim the Firstborn to reanimate anything that gets milled with Stitcher Supplier, or just straight up killed. And it's got Village Raids to draw cards in combo with Claim the Firstborn. It's a pretty low to the ground deck, but it can grind very well, especially with Croaks against sort of slower mid-range ramp and control decks. In the sideboard, we've got 3 Duress against control and mid-range, mostly Soul Tie these days, Magma Strain and Redcap Melee against aggro and creature decks, a Braid both against creature decks and against Grabtigger's Cage primarily, though it's good against Godfrow's Gift decks as well. Witch's Vengeance against Goblins, of course, it's a huge deck these days, and Witch's Vengeance is a huge blowout for them. And 3 Hazoreth the Fervent. So, in my deck guide in the description, I had 3 Pack Rats instead of Hazoreth the Fervent, but Luis Salvato played 3 Hazoreths in his list that he took to the Mythic Invitational. He's actually playing it, as the Mythic Invitational isn't over yet, and I thought I'd give it a try. It's sort of a backup plan if the opponent has a Grafdigger's Cage or a Rest in Peace or a Leyline of the Void, and our main game plan gets shut off. Hazoreth the Fervent can really just dish out the damage, especially against an opponent that's, for example, mulligan to a Leyline and can't interact meaningfully with Hazard and everything else. It's sort of like a second angle of attack. So that's the deck, and let's jump into the games. Alrighty. Playing against Orion Pax, I will in fact be on the play, and this hand looks solid. Turn to Young Pyromancer is not something I will give up with a lot of enthusiasm, as it can take over the game if it's not interacted with. No Thoughts is a little bit unfortunate, but on turn 3 we can Croaks it, claim Croaks, get 2 1-1s, and make our opponent discard 2, and there aren't a mulligan, so that's going to be even better. And mana's perfect. No Castle Lockthwain. Ooh, goblins. So this matchup's pretty good because we've got plenty of removal, and Skroxa will rip their hands to shreds, especially if they get off to a fast start. I am actually considering Spark Harvest. So if they have a Muxus, they can cast it next turn, provided they also have a land, which would suck. But Spark Harvest, I'll be only be able to cast it by sacrificing either my Young Pyromancer or a Dreadhorde Arcanist. Collateral damage would be much better on this spot. So I think what I'm going to do is cast Croaks. Earlier I misspoke, by the way. I'm only going to get 1 token as Young Pyromancer. It triggers off instants and sorceries. So they discarded a Goblin War Chief, which makes me suspicious. Unfortunately, if they don't have a Muxus, I'm still going to lose this game if I sacrifice my Young Pyromancer. If they just go Chieftain attack me, I'm not going to be able to mount a proper defense in time. Second War Chief discarded, so that makes it more likely that they don't have a Muxus. And even if they do have a Muxus, if they get unlucky with their Muxus, no, it's a Krenko. So, now this is actually, I got pretty rewarded for my play last turn, because now I get to Spark Harvest Krenko. The token replaces itself, and I've got this Dreadhorde Arcanist to kill a creature next turn. They had to sacrifice a Goblin to get Krenko down. He's not going to get to activate, and now hopefully they're left with not very much due to this Croaksa, which will come back pretty shortly, especially with this Fabled Passage. And I'm just going to pass the turn over here. Don't think there's any need to do anything. Just see how much my opponent can do. Oh, that's pretty bad for me. But I can reanimate a croak, which seems pretty good. This fabled passage. Double thought sees. Not really what I want to see when I'm discarding my opponent's last card. I mean, at best, it's just a card in the graveyard. I think I'm going to leave Dreadhorde Arcanist in the graveyard for Lurrus to reanimate. Play Croaks, in hindsight... No, it was correct. They did have a Moxus, and they just didn't go for it. Maybe they drew it after they played the Krenko. Okay, so this Croaks, I would not be surprised if they traded two creatures for it, but I wouldn't mind it either. I think they shouldn't, because that means drawing a Moxus is a good out. And if they trade here, they'll only have 5 mana, provided they don't draw anything. This Castle Lockwind, of course, makes it so that they have enough power to trade. So here, I'm just going to play the Young Pyromancer and bring Lurrus to hand. I could Thoughtseize them to have blockers, just to make 1/1s. The creatures, but I wouldn't be able to block Chain Whirler anyway, and Lurrus means I get to play Dreadhorde Arcanist as well next turn. Interesting to see what they do here. If they swing out a little bit overzealously, then I could have lethal. So they conceded, not particularly surprising, though I would have waited if I was them one more turn just to see if I could draw a Moxus and win that way, but either way I won't complain. Get rid of this more clunky removal. Vessel not doing particularly much. I think I can go down a Young Pyromancer as well. And I think I will run it like this. Is there anything else I want to change? Might actually go down to 3 Thoughtseize. Bring in another claim. A little bit awkward that really there's no glaringly bad card to sideboard out. Croaks, it does get a little bit worse against sort of aggressive decks, but never going want to go down to 0 because milling one over a Stitcher Supplier is always great, and it's really the main way that I want to take over the game. Turn 1 Skurk Prospector would be unfortunate. Claim the Firstborn is 1 mana removal for it, but the way, still would rather not see. I want to Thoughtseize here on turn 2 in case they have a really awkward hand. I would say this is an awkward hand. I could take Gem Palm Incinerator, but it's not doing very much, so I think I'll just take Snoop. It's between Snoop and Skurk Prospector. But I think I'm going to take Snoop so they don't get any card advantage. I think next turn I'm just playing two Stitcher Suppliers. Really want to fire off this Village Rites after Claim the Firstborn, which is a little bit hard with the Skurk Prospector out, but shouldn't be too hard to maneuver myself into a position where that's good. Okay, so that means that Witch's Vengeance of the Graveyard is actually good. It means that if I get a Dreadhorde Arcanist and a Claim, I can flash it back. Phyrexian Tower is a good draw for them, and good Goblin War Chief, so that's a little bit unfortunate. I'm gonna claim this, but I fully expect to sacrifice to Skurk Prospector. And now, this Gem Palm Incinerator is starting to get into range. Stitcher Supplier, I can sack one of them to draw cards, hopefully find a Croaksa as well. And this Gem Palm Incinerator is not going to kill a Croaksa anytime soon, especially without a Krenko. I'm just going to play a Tapland and pass the turn. If I Village Rites now, there are certain cards for 1 mana that I might want to play, but I want to sort of see what they do first. Playing a Tapland is also nice, so I don't have to take damage later in the game. And had they gone for a Gem Palm Incinerator, it would have been good as well. Okay, so now Claim is a very good draw. Unfortunately didn't get there. Claim to Fame, that is not Claim the Firstborn. Though I wouldn't mind to Claim the Firstborn as well. Not much I can do here. I'm just going to pass the turn since this shuts off their attacks. Unless they, of course, have Braid or Gem Palm Incinerator, which is more than fine. Which, they might draw cards. Wily Goblin means that Oxus is not far off at all, but I would be surprised if that's what they got. I am going to, however, go for this Lurrus. It's a little bit unfortunate that they'll be able to Gem Palm Incinerator, but I'll be able to get down a Dreadhorde Arcanist before then and start drawing cards with this Village Rites. Yep. Interesting to see them sacrifice the treasure here. It means they don't have a Muxus. That card's not a Muxus, as they wouldn't do that. And now I think I'm safe to attack. Probably going to see an upgrade on my Dreadhorde Arcanist, but that means I can't develop their board any further. They didn't draw something cheap, which is fine by me. Take my beats here and expect I'll be untapping. Alright, so that's a pretty big draw. I'm going to fire off now to delay any potential Muxi. Hopefully that's the correct plural for Muxuses. Though, pronunciation of magic names is not a strong suit of really much of anyone. Goblin Chieftain and Goblin Instigator, so that's a little bit worrying. I would like to get to activating this priest, but I can't just hard cast this Spark Harvest. Pay full retail for it. And I think I'll just hold back here. Probably going to chump and sack. There, move my priest, the Forgotten Gods. Now, I'll just block. I'm fine with trading. This Village Rites could also be potentially good if I draw a claim. And if I mill over Kroxa, there we go. See, that's why I don't cut too many of them. Just a land for my opponent, which is pretty ideal. Claim the Firstborn off the top is a great draw. I'm going to start by getting rid of lands. Lurrus is gone, can't bring it back. Get rid of that. Got two Spark Harvests in here, and gotta find the last card. I'll get rid of it, Braid. It is often worth it to take the time to make sure that you aren't discarding, or rather exiling the wrong card when you're escaping, because you may end up needing it later in the game. Please excuse, by the way, the fact that I'm in Diamond right now. Usually, and I mean, this is like the classic excuse, but usually I get to Mythic within 48 hours, but between sort of getting burnt out a little bit and going away on a very nice trip to the White Mountains, I've not been able to get to Mythic yet, but I will in the near future, I promise. So for some reason, waiting on my opponent here. So, again, my opponent's conceding prematurely, as they could cast a Muxus if they drew it, but yes, it is only Diamond 4. Maybe more for them, actually. Looks like they're in Diamond 2, if I'm correct. Anyway, picked up my first win, and 100 gold to boot, and let's jump into another one. Playing match 2 against Izuk. Hopefully I pronounced that right, but I also doubt there's a correct pronunciation, so here we are. This is an interesting hand. Dreadhorde Arcanist is by far my best card, but three of them know their spells. I think this has to be a mulligan. If I draw a Thoughtseize, I'm going to be sad, though. Or rather, if the next card was a Thoughtseize, I would have regretted it. So, going to 5. A little bit unfortunate. I get rid of Spark Harvest and a Dragon Skull Summit here. and, well, I'll be able to recoup some card advantage by eating their expect it's going to be a Lovestruck Beast coming down. I would be surprised if they just adventured it. Ooh, a Gruul Spellbreaker. So I am going to just slam that back into their face. Would have rather they didn't ride it, but I think that is ultimately the correct play. Just nice card neutral removal. Definitely not busted at all. Gets me a little bit out of this mulligan. Now, adventure Lovestruck Beast, play Lovestruck Beast. So, Ambercleave would be pretty bad here. Otherwise, I would love to draw either Claim the Firstborn or Village Rights, so that I can pair it with the one in the graveyard to kill this Lovestruck Beast, which is sort of a problem right now. That aside, I'd have 5 cards in the graveyard if I jumped a Croix that is bigger than anything they've got. Ooh, is this a Dami's Ambush? It's not great. Primal Knight. Okay, that's definitely not great. That means I need to draw something or I'm dead next turn. And okay, so drew a Dreadhorde Arcanist. Chump block, Croxa. So I need them to draw land and they'll be able to escape Croxa. They'll be able to attack me down to 1 though. But after that, I'll be able to get Lurrus if I draw land. Still going to be very close though. This is probably an Embercleave if they're holding priority. Or a Bone Crusher. Or literally any other creature provided I don't draw something and I'm still screwed. Well, opponent pretty much got the nuts against me. And I did mulligan. So, bringing these hazards, I think. Braid, this removal. I'm gonna take out my Thought Seizes, Rock Fiend's Vessels a little bit. Lackluster. 2 Croxas. Yeah, and cut a young Peasy as well. So the question is, do I want Hazards or do I want Lurrus? And I'm not really sure which it is. Hazaret does block very well, but I might just want to be doing my normal game plan, so honestly, I'll just do that. Vengeance. Fortunately, not great. Would have liked to have a Heartless Act on the sideboard here, but not very many people play Gruul. Either way, this is a good matchup because the Claim the Firstborn and all the cheap removal. Got a little bit unlucky game 1, but hopefully I'll be able to get there later. This hand. I'll keep it on the back of this Bedevil. If I draw a Stitcher Supplier, a Village Rights, any of those cards, even like a 2-drop that I can trade off and then claim back, then this hand gets a whole lot better. And this Fabled Passage on turn 1 means I can cast this Bedevil without any problems. Pass the turn. Interesting to see if they lead on turn 1 Land Elves or not. I'd rather they didn't, of course. As even if I drew a Magma Spread, it's still not great. Okay, well, I'll be cracking now because I don't want to draw more lands. Play. Ooh. That's pretty much the perfect draw. And with Bedevil as well means I've got their first 2 creatures covered and I've got time to bring Lurrus to hand. So, it's actually coming quite nicely. Whew. And a young Pyromancer, so I get to get some tokens and a card. This game's just over. I mean, my opponent kept a hand with no 1 or 2 drops. Not sure what they were thinking. Croxa, nice. And while it does have Hexproof from black, when you sack your own thing, Hexproof doesn't matter. Spark Harvest to go with Claim the Firstborn. I mean, if I were that kind of person, I would definitely early GG them right now, because they're not coming back from this. So they have a collected company, but I have a million removal spells, so I'll attack. Worst comes to worst, I can always claim back this young pyromancer anyway. Cool, so no hexproof, so I'll just kill you. Kill you. Response, don't want that thing to go to a 3-3. There are many ways I could have avoided that. My opponent for 4. And I think that's it. So unless I have a flame sweep into Questing Beast plus removal, this game's pretty much over. I mean, it's very hard for them to come back here. I'm ahead on card advantage, ahead on board. I've got straight gas in hand. And so a second collected company, and I'm sort of out of removal, or out of instant speed removal, so now I won't be overzealous in terms of attacking, but I can escape this Croxa, so it's got to be pretty good. You can't kill me with Embercleave, and I'll be able to kill them on the crackback, because of this claim, or just because I can remove all their creatures. Garuk's Harbinger discarded. That's an actual card. A little bit worrying to see that, honestly. I'll leave a village rights in the graveyard. I think that's best. Nothing that I need to worry about in terms of bringing back with Luris. So, I just need to play around Dreadhorde Arcanist. Or other play towards Dreadhorde Arcanist. And here I'll just pass the turn. Don't want to trade off my young Pyromancer for nothing. Yeah, especially since they're discarding all these 3 drops. They've definitely got a collected company here. Hopefully it's not too good. Chain Whirler would actually kind of suck. Well, Rampaging Phyrexidon. That I'm not too worried about. I mean, it is good against me, certainly. It's good against young Pyromancer, but not here. Yeah, they just go to 10, and fortunately for them, it is over. So, game 3, do I want to change anything? Don't think so. Yeah, I think I'll just be running it back here. Nazareth, a little bit awkward when you're ahead. You've got a bunch of cards in hand. And against Ghoul, I'm pretty rarely going to have enough mana to just start discarding stuff like that. Especially since it only goes face.
Currently waiting for Azuk to do some
game 3 sideboarding. Opponents on the play, a little bit unfortunate. I mean, of course they're on the play. I will keep this hand. Worst comes to worst, it's a turn 3 Pyromancer. Love to draw Claim the Firstborn. This Priest is actually a good draw. Though I may just hold up Village Rights. Okay, that's bad for me. Is certainly bad for me. I'll just go ahead and play this Priest in that case. Try to force some removal. I do have Spark Harvest for the Scavenging Ooze, but that is a 2-drop that I need to remove, which is not great.
Interesting to see what they do here.
If they don't have anything, I can probably pop off this young Pyromancer in combination with Priest of the Forgotten Gods. It's a little bit awkward that all my stuff requires to sacrifice the token, so they're not net positive on bodies. No blocks here. And second young pyromancer. So I think what I'm doing here is just chump blocking and casting village rites. I wish I could get the life off Arcanist's vessel, but it's probably not going to be the case, since that's what I need to sacrifice, and unfortunately, I will be pretty dead to an Embercleave on Harbinger, unless I draw a claim the firstborn. I mean, I'll probably just be pretty dead to it, because damage. I don't think I'm chump blocking. I will have to just play as if they don't have it, because I don't think I can beat one. But if they had one, they might not have deliberated for this long. So that's a good sign. If they just jammed that attack all button, I'd know pretty much for sure that they'd have it. Still just waiting on my opponent. Maybe their internet is bad, I don't know. Questing beast. Well, don't love to see that for sure. Going to be taking a solid chunk of damage here. Putting me all the way down to one life, which is not great. But I don't think I can do anything else, really. Okay. Pyromancer. Sacrifice a creature. Destroy a questing beast. This one. Spell collector has trample though. That's quite bad. Sacrifice a creature. Probably gonna sack Guruk's Harbinger. Hopefully they sacrifice spell collector, but pretty much impossible. And now any sort of like bone crusher kills me, and I still need to draw something off this priest either way, so it's definitely not looking great. That is a claim the firstborn, but it's a little bit too late. Does let me. Untap priest. Activate priest again. And they. No, they're gonna sack their scavenging ooze, and now I'm dead. Oh, okay, well, they had the Gruul Spellbreaker as well. Yeah. That Clan the Firstborn was just one card near that game. Could have been in my favor, but whatever. I got the beats delivered to me by Gruul, rough mulligan to 5 in game 1, and game 3 I just got run over. Either way, match number 3 against Bernardo. On the draw. Opponent's really taking a while to decide if they want to go first. I assume that's just them being slow rather than some sort of control deck that wants to be on a draw, because that would be pretty surprising. Gruul. Gruul indeed. Well, that is Clan the Firstborn plus Village Rites, so that's what I want to see. Certainly. Don't mind that at all. Still just waiting on my opponent here. Is this like a light up the stage? No. Alright, I see your Pelt Collector and I match you a young Pyromancer. no turn one Pell Collector is good. But that probably means they didn't have a better 3 drop. And, yep, Bone Crusher. A little bit unfortunate. But. Boom. That's actually an interesting spot. So I could go for Thoughtseize. I could play Stitcher Supplier, which is what I'm going to do since they're just going to play a 3 drop next turn. And then I'm going to just pass the turn. No sense claiming here. Maybe I should have tried auto-passing a little bit faster so it would be clear that they had it. But this is not the upper reaches of Mythic, so I don't think I need to be worried that much. Opponent enjoys being a tank. They do it very often. Gruul player taking 2 minutes. I have taken 1 minute. 2 minutes, of course, isn't much to be complaining about, but yep, love struck beast. As expected. Not gonna block here. Not gonna be that hasty about getting rid of my Stitcher Supplier, especially since it means that I can attack with my Lovestruck Beast. They're a Lovestruck Beast, but it's mine now. And the good thing about rooting this way is they don't get a counter on their Pelt Collector. Probably going to Thoughtseize them right after this as well. Yes, I am. Don't want to die to an Embercleave. Okay, we're definitely going to take Scavenging Ooze and then take the Trampler. Seems good. All these Gruul players with Scavenging Ooze is a little bit annoying, but honestly, Gruul has. I have more things to be worried about from Gruul than just their Scavenging Oozes. And if they're spending a bunch of mana just eating my graveyard, that's more fine than like a Sultai deck that goes growth spiraling and then has a million. Excuse me! Buying the card I thought seized. Classic. Classic Gruul maneuver. Better lucky than good, what can I say? It is good that they're still going to lose this game, though. Yep, eat my Stitcher Supplier, that's fine. Got an entire army of 1/1s. And I'm totally fine to trade essentially 1.5 for 1. Okay, Bunker's Giant, that is totally fine. Is pretty chonky. I'd like to get that thing out of here. Unless they drew a Giant Growth, in which case it would be a blowout, but my 2 drop better than their 1 drop. Love to see it. So, hopefully they don't discard the Kenra. Because that means that good, and don't have a proper removal spell in the graveyard quite yet. That's an Embercleave. They're gonna have to throw away their 1/1.
But I will take 10 damage, meaning I can't
target their Bone Crusher. That's not ideal. Probably have to double block then. Just to take off some damage from the trample. I would much rather they just had some sort of plain old removal spell here. And I guess discarding the Earthshaker Kenra isn't as bad because of the Eternalize. And Earthshaker Kenra is still worse than Rona's. Most things. Indestructible. so it's not great, but it's actually totally fine. Because now they don't have a 4 power creature. Take 2 damage. It's fine. Spark Harvest. And then attack here. Flashback, Spark Harvest, sack a creature. Just to try to finish out the game here. Not bringing back Kroxa because I don't want to start taking beats from this Rhonos. And this means that unless they have something very impressive, they're not going to be able to Embercleave me since this Rhonos can't attack. And Urshika Kenra, 1 mana off, so unless they have Pyretic Ritual, which isn't on Arena, I'm going to be totally safe from it.
Yup, Bone Crush, that's pretty good. But I don't think it's good enough.
Just jumping here. Don't think there's much point in trying to get all low and close to being dead and all that. So basically need to dodge a Embercleave this turn, and I've got this game in the bag. Sort of missing my Spark Harvest now, but I still think that was a fine play. And just pass the turn over. No point suiciding Dreadhorde Arcanists and dealing myself 2 damage and all that. So if they have a removal spell for Kroxa, I can reanimate it next turn. That means they'll be empty-handed, so it's 3 damage, so they're going to have to be really careful about their life total, especially since I've got... I guess I've got Claim and Village Rights, so I could have attacked with both Dreadhorde Arcanists and killed a creature. Maybe I should have done that. Either way, I need to make sure that I'm not dead to an Embercleave here. And then I've got this game in the bag. Actually, I might just block like this. 12? No, that's not good. To block like this, so they Embercleave and put me to 1, put me to 7. So they put me at 2 here on the Dreadhorde Arcanist, or 12 on the Rhonos, minus 4, putting me to 1, and that's all their mana. Well, they only have 1 card in hand, so it's good enough, and now it's going to be pretty hard for them to get out of this. That was weird. Why did I do that? Maybe I should have blocked with the Kroxa, actually. Because if they have a blocker here... Actually, I really messed that up. No, that was very bad. Well, never punished, I guess, but jeez, I played that really badly, actually. I should have just traded off my Kroxa, and then I would have just grabbed a thing with the Arcanists, drawn a bunch of cards, been able to escape Kroxa again. Yeah, so I played that actually really badly. Don't do what I did. Two these out here. Go down. And I think that's good. Oh, sorry, no, just gonna get rid of all these Thoughtseize real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4. Totally forgot about that. Thoughtseize, not great against an aggro deck. The loss of life is pretty bad, and their curve is pretty tight anyway. It's nowhere near as bad as, for example, taking Growth Spiral against Zoltai when you take their 2 drop and they have to play a 1 drop instead. On the draw, would rather be on the play than the draw. I think this is a keep. Two removal spells. I'll take it. Three removal spells. I'm actually going to just shock this in, meaning I have red cap melee for the three drop. And if I draw something, then it gives me a little more flexibility. If I draw a true drop, that'll be a little bit of a punish. Of course. Yep, and now they get to play their Lovestruck Beast, which doesn't die to this red cap melee. Just kidding. Gonna kill that before it starts stealing cards from me. Which I don't appreciate. Crack this now, because Landowner's tapped. Going to lead on Young Pyromancer, because I think in this case it's less valuable, because this Claim the Firstborn plus the Priest is a huge blowout if I can pull it off. Opponent hitting their land drops. Shocking. Definitely didn't see that one coming. I'll just go ahead and play a Priest of Forgotten Gods, hold up this Braid for whatever they've got. I assume there's a Bone Crusher coming, or at least I wouldn't be surprised by one. Okay, well, I'd rather see Shock than Bone Crusher, because then I'm trading one for one. And soon I can bring a Slurs to hand and start going to town. I would actually rather see that than this Lovestruck Beast, because it walks very nicely into this Braid. Boom. And don't think I'm going to get punished for doing that main phase rather than any other time. Village Rites plus Claim the Firstborn. Love to see it. Honestly, I've been really consistent in pulling it off right after I hit the record button. Usually doesn't happen that much when I'm not recording, I guess. It's the whole content creator whitelist. I do appreciate. So I guess I did multi 5. Okay, so get in 4-5. See if they chump block. They do not. 1-1 is important to them, though I imagine it actually is pretty important to them because of the second Lovestruck Beast. Now I'll just draw a couple of cards and pass the turn, probably bedevil something or on their end step, because I want to get value out of this Lures before I throw it away into a potential Bone Crusher or Shock. Okay, Robber of the Ridge. That's fine. I'm going to kill it now because I don't want them drawing cards. But this does mean that they do get to play the Lovestruck Beast. I don't have a Chump Walker for it, but then... No. Oh, yeah, they are. Okay. A little bit surprised. I would have been a little bit surprised if they didn't go for it. I'm going to play the Priest here, as I would rather have it not summoning sick, and actually I would rather have it on the battlefield, period. Won't be surprised to see removal on Lurus. Yeah, my opponent's on Gruul Control or something. Really been jamming that removal. Pelt Collector, it's fine. So, Lovestruck Beast, attack, and I will activate Priest post-combat. A little bit awkward that I'm flooding. Hopefully I can draw Kroxa or Milikroxa or draw something good. My opponent is on 8 as well, but if they draw something that's not great. Take my beats for now. On top, probably a land, but if it's a cocoa then I need to find out right about now. Is not a Coco. Okay, well that's game then. Because now they can't win. So that's nice. And ending 2-1 today. Advanced a little bit closer to Mythic. Probably grind for a couple of hours. some point get the rest of the way there. So, get my 50 gold and my Sir Farron. So, as I said before, this is the deck list. I wrote an article on it, link in the description down below. It's pretty sweet. Went 2-1 today in matches. Though it is in diamonds, so I wouldn't put too much merit in it. And obviously, small sample size, all that, so don't put stock into what I do. Play the deck for yourself. Get to know how good it is. Luis Salvato has been absolutely crushing it in the Mythic Invitational with this deck. So good luck to him. This deck list is partially inspired by his, though they're all a couple smaller changes. With that being said, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did, and I will hopefully see you in the next one.